What's up, guys, and welcome back to talking while driving, which is what I'm currently doing. I know some of you might be wondering, what the heck, man? You're supposed to do these on Wednesday at home on the microphone, but that's not what this is, obviously. So I'd like to first apologize for the sound quality, because obviously it's not going to sound as good as a real a phone microphone isn't going to sound as good as a like an actual microphone. So I apologize for that. What was I going to say? I guess I could have done it the last 2 days, but the reason. If this works out, hopefully there'll be some kind of gameplay going while I talk. I don't necessarily, I don't know how long this one's gonna be. I'm thinking it's probably gonna be on the not close. I'm thinking it's probably gonna be on the 40 to 45 minute side. That's at least what I'm aiming for. But I guess I should start by saying, I guess it was either Monday or Tuesday, and I was playing my PlayStation 4, and I was trying to make space because I had like no space on my PlayStation 4, so I was trying to make space so that I could what is it? So that I could record gameplay for this video, and I'm really hoping that it works, because this I'm gonna be sounding really stupid if there's no gameplay playing, because I don't have the picture for a show for no name. So if I if I don't have gameplay, I don't have that picture either, so I have to make something else up. So if there's something else up on there, it's because I'm not at home and I don't have all my stuff. But around Tuesday or Wednesday, while trying to make space, I accidentally deleted all the games off of my PlayStation, including the one that's hopefully playing right now. So I had to like reinstall all my games for the last 2 or 3 days, which it actually does take a good little bit of time. Plus, I had like DLCs, so I had to re-download those. And let me just say right now that my internet is slow. Slow as a snail. Look at that simile. But yeah, my internet's really slow, so it takes a long time to download, upload, or whatever. So that's, hopefully it'll be up by today, because I'm gonna try to do it at school, and they have, I guess, not, they don't really have fast internet, but they have faster internet. Their internet's not necessarily crap. But hope everyone's having a good day. I mean, I actually have to work today, tonight. And the reason I'm doing this now in the car, I don't know if I really explained this because I've just been rambling pretty much, but I didn't do it yesterday or the day before because I was playing Black Ops 3, the Zombies DLC Revelations, and I'm trying to get that Easter egg done, yo. So that's I was like Friday, I knew I wasn't gonna do it Friday because I got off early too, because I normally get off at 11, but yesterday I got off at 9, and I'm like, I'm going home and I'm working on this Easter egg. There's no doubt about it. So there was no shot at all that I was gonna do it yesterday. And hopefully this, I just thought about this. Hopefully this doesn't sound too loud, 'cause normally on the microphone it limits how loud it can be, but on the phone I don't think it really cares. I don't think it cares how loud or how soft I talk. So I'll hopefully. Once I get to the school, once I get on one of these Mac computers, I can edit it up right, and we can be sounding as clear as I guess possible. But it's guaranteed that it's gonna sound different from the other ones. But the reason why I'm not doing this in the evening today is because the same thing. When I get home, I'm working on that Revelations Easter egg. No doubt about it. I am not doing this podcast later on today. So that's why I'm doing it right now. But yeah, I just feel like it's, I don't know why, I just feel like it's gonna be a very good day. Oh, the sun is shining. The sun is shining. There's not a cloud in the sky. And I know y'all like, what is this, man? I'm just trying to spread the positivity, you know? Cause I'm feeling really chill right now. Feeling really good. But I guess let's get into this stuff that I'm gonna talk about. And forgive me if I pause for like a second, because obviously I'm driving with one hand and I'm holding the phone that I'm recording with the other hand. But the phone that I actually have on me, that the phone that I'm recording on isn't my actual, the phone that I make calls and stuff on. And that's the one that has like the stuff that I'm gonna talk about. I think I'll be able to remember it, but that's the one that has the stuff that I'm gonna talk about on it. So if I pause for a second just to remember or look at what I wrote down, then please forgive me for that. But let's get into it. Okay, so let me just say, I don't know how, this probably might not even be this long, what I'm about to talk about right now. But my week did not start off very good, okay? So, when was it? So I had to be at work, I guess, at 5 on Sunday. And so I was leaving, and I don't know what my nephew was doing, but I was looking back at him. And I opened the garage, and I'm looking back at him. And so he's doing whatever he does. And so I'm like, oh, whatever. So I turn around, right? And I walk into the garage, and I scar up my head. And I have a big scar on my, I didn't even know, but I have a big scar on my left shoulder. And so I'm here grimacing in pain. If that's even, I don't even know if that's a word or if that's even the way to phrase that. But here I am in agonizingly bad. I'm in pain, okay? So I'm holding my head and I'm holding my shoulder. And I'm like, I was like, that hurt. And my nephew, who's like 5, well, he turned 6 like this week, but he's like 5, and he's like, what was that? He's like, what was that? That was a, like, idiot. Like, my nephew's low-key calling me an idiot. And I'm like, I'm looking back at you trying to see what you're doing. And that's why I ran into the freaking garage. And so I'm just like, man. I'm like, I hate that somebody saw that. Even a 5-year-old. I hate that somebody saw that. But I'm glad that he didn't laugh. Because I feel like most kids would laugh at something like that. He didn't laugh at me. So he has a heart. He has a soul. But when I was still in pain, I get into the car and I'm like, well, at least I got my stupid thing of the week out of the way early. So that's what I'm concerned about. I'm just glad that I got my stupidity out of my system early. Got it before work, before school this week. So I'm like, I'm good for the rest of the that. After that, there's nowhere to go but up. That's the way I'm looking at it. So I'm like, yeah, I'm gonna be all right now. But let me see. I'm gonna pull my phone out right quick, cause I can't. Oh, never mind. I do remember. So I think it was. It was multiple days. But what was that? But that was actually meant to be one of the funny things. Even though it wasn't funny to me, but I can see how other people would think that was funny. But that was just one of my funny things for the week. The other funny thing that happened was, I kid you not, this video, I was in the, it's not really a lot, it's like a computer lab, but I was in there crying, laughing, and people were definitely, I'm not exaggerating at all. I exaggerate 99% of the time, but this right here is the 1% that I'm being completely truthful. I kid you not, people were staring at me in the computer lab because of how hard I was laughing. Man, I don't know if y'all have seen this video, and I don't know if I'm late. I'm not late on it, because this was my first time watching the original versions of it months ago. I saw like a, and I think I looked up the meme, and I think it is from 2015, which I'm pretty sure I watched it back then in near 2015. But anyway, if y'all haven't seen this video where this dude's like, look at this dude, and he's making fun of people. That jet was so, it's not even funny because of him some of them are funny because he's making fun of people, but the majority of the time it's funny because this dude's laugh is so contagious. Just his laugh alone is what makes me laugh. That jump was just so funny. It was like 14 minutes long, and I was covering my mouth. I was trying so hard to not bust out laughing, and I bust one out, and the guy was looking at me, and I was like, I'm good, bro. You need to watch this. This junk is funny. But yeah, if y'all need a good laugh, go look up that stuff, man. Cause I kid you not, I was crying, and I think a lot. Me, it's easy to make me laugh. I think almost, I wouldn't say that because the next thing that I'm going to talk about would completely oppose that. But if it's funny, if it's generally funny, I'm going to laugh because I'm not that hard to please. I think a lot of stuff is funny. But I think one of the funniest ones I saw is this dude. His head was legitimately shaped like a potato. And the guy was like, he was like, whose dad is this? And then they were showing like pictures of potatoes and like an egg. That joke was brown eggs. That joke was so funny. I was busting out laughing. But yeah, I just wanted to share that with y'all. What's the other thing that I was going to talk about for a second? Oh, yeah. I was going to talk about if jokes aren't funny, I'm not going to give you a pity laugh. No chance. Like, if you're going to bring the jokes, you bring the bars. You bring the fire. Because I don't laugh at funny this guy. You pull out right in freaking front of me. Freaking killing me, man. Oh, I'm not legitimately mad. But before I even talk about these jokes not being funny, let me talk about this because it's on my mind right now. If you're going to drive slow, don't drive in the left lane. If you're going to drive slow, drive in the right lane. I am sick of tired. Yeah, I'm sick of tired. I'm tired of being tired. I'm sick of it. But if you're like, drive right, okay? If you're driving slow, you're driving in the right lane. And like, I can deal with you driving slow as crap in the right lane, because there's the left, that's what the left lane is for, so I can pass your slow driving butt. But if you're driving slow in the left lane, I gotta try to get in front of the person driving slow in the right lane just so I can get around you and get back in the left lane. So please, people, please. I'm not guilty of this. Right now, I'm in the right lane. I passed that guy that pulled out in front of me because he's a jerk. But other than that, I drive fast in the right lane because I'm a boss. And while I'm thinking of this, I am on the exact road where I saw my friend driving yesterday. And I doubt that she listens to this, but I guarantee that if she does, she will know exactly who I'm talking about. You drive too fast. You need to slow it down. If I'm driving 65, well, I'm probably not driving 60. I'm trying to not exaggerate. But if I'm driving 55 in a 45 and I'm not even close to you, you got to be going at least 65 in the 45, which is speeding. And I'm probably speeding too, but you're way out there. So you need to slow. If you're listening to this, I know that you know who you are, because you basically have a sports car. So you need to slow down your driving. That's about it I'm going to say about driving. Let me pass this one other person. I need to get into the left lane anyway because I'm about to turn soon. But I was talking about jokes. And the reason I brought this up is because of ongoing jokes at works, ongoing jokes at work by customers, because two or three of the most, I don't know if I'll be able to come up with three, but here are just some of the jokes that I hear at work. Like I've heard like hundreds of times. Like I'll just be standing there and they'll be like, "Oh, let me give you something to do." And here I am behind a bus. Oh, this should be fun. But they'll be like, "Oh, you don't look like you're doing nothing. Let me give you something to do." They'll say something like that. Or they'll say, the other one they say is, what do they say? It's something about, if a barcode or something won't scan, they'll be like, "Oh, I guess I get it free." And if I ever laugh, I'm laughing at them because I'm like, "Yeah, right. You're not getting this for free. You gotta pay. You picked it up. You didn't pick it up." And that's another thing. Let me get on this right. I didn't think I was gonna talk about work today, but people are hypocrites because they will let you know about. I have no problem if it rang up wrong. I have no problem with you letting me know that it rung up wrong. But when it rings up wrong and it's cheaper, I need you to be the same way. I need you to still be like, "Oh, it rung up wrong. It's supposed to be more." Because most people, if it rings up too high, they'll let you know about it. But if it rings up too low, they won't say nothing. So people, please be honest. Have a little bit of integrity, because that's not right. You can't be playing both sides of the fence, you know? You can't have your cake and eat it too, if that even applies. I don't know what I just. It's the morning time. If anything I'm saying sounds, like extremely stupid or excessive, more stupid than normal, then it's the morning time. Like, my brain hasn't developed. I guess I'm up. I don't know. I'm driving. I guess I'm up, but I'm not there yet. If that makes any sense. But dang it, I'm almost to my destination. I'll just talk in the car for a few minutes if I have to. It's gonna be hot. I live in Georgia. Going off topic. I'm still on the jokes things, but I'm going off topic for a few minutes because I don't think this is gonna go that long. So anything I think of, I'm gonna pretty much talk about it. I live in Georgia, and normally in Georgia, there's no such thing as fall and spring. We go pretty much, there's like a 2-week period that you could, I guess, call spring. And there's like a 2-week period that you could call fall. But for the most part, in Georgia, we have summer and winter, and that's it. And honestly, I don't think we're going to get winter this year. I don't think we're going to get winter this year. We might get spring this year because I don't think we're going to get winter yet. It is September and it is still hot. It was 100 degrees yesterday. I don't know if that's like official, but that's what my thermostat on my car said. It said it was 100 degrees yesterday and it is mid-September. What is fall, autumn, fall, like in a few days, and it's still this hot? Oh man, it's like it's really hot. And but I, like I said one time on Facebook, I was like, the same people complaining about how hot it is right now will be complaining about how cold it is in a few months, which is true. So just quit complaining about the weather. If it's hot, take your shirt off. If it's cold, put one on. It's simple. This is pre-K. If it's hot, take your shirt off. If it's cold, put one on. Come on, people. But back to this joke thing at work. So they'll be like, whatever. They'll be like, "Oh, I guess I get it free," or "Let me give you something to do." And 100% of the time they say that crap. All I wanna say is, I want to say it just like this. I want to be like, "You know what? I've heard that joke 300 times. But after the 301st time, it's still not funny. That joke will never be funny. I'm up here trying to chill and you want to come through my line? What do you think I'm here to do, work? No, I'm here to play. I'm here to talk to friends. I'm here to chill. So come on now, go to somebody, I'm closed. Go to somebody else's line. And I apologize so much. I'll put like if you're wearing headphones, I'll put like a headphone warning if I can't like turn the volume down. I apologize so much for that. But I was passionate about that. That joke will never be, I'm not laughing at that joke. It's not funny. If you tell funny jokes, I'm gonna laugh. If you don't tell funny jokes, I'm not gonna laugh. One, I'll be a liar. And I'm not wasting my smiles. I'm not wasting my good vibes on you. I need these just in case. Talking about, man, they can't seriously think that's funny. One day I'm gonna muster up the courage. I'm gonna be like, that's never been funny. You know that, right? Who came up with that joke? Who came up with that? Because it's not funny. Talking about I get it for free. You don't get it for free. When you picked it up, you weren't thinking, oh, I'm going to get this for free. You thought, oh, how much does this cost? The first thing you did was look at the price. Talking about you get it for free. You weren't back there talking about you get it for free. I don't know why I was talking so fast right there. Wow. I apologize. I'm doing a lot of apologizing this week. But it's all good. But yeah, guys, just a public service announcement funded by the Ad Council. Get out of the road, sir. My goodness. Turn! These people, people don't know how to drive, y'all. The light is green and you can turn right. You can turn right on red, okay? So if the light is green, you better be freaking turning. You're killing me, man. You're killing me. But just a public service announcement. If you're gonna tell a joke, make sure it's funny. And while I'm really close to where I'm parking, which I park at, I'm not gonna say which park. Not as if somebody's gonna find me and kill me or whatever. But it doesn't really, Lay Park, that's where I park. Okay, oh, I'm a savage, not really. But I park at Lay Park. But somebody's gonna key my car and slash my tires. But like, cause you're not gonna get me. You're gonna be waiting there for like 6 hours just to get me. Totally not worth it. But so the football game, the reason I'm bringing the park up, cause it's gonna make sense in a minute. So the football game, I went to the football game, the Georgia football game Saturday, right? And I'm going to keep it real with you guys. I did not have a good time. I did not enjoy. I think somebody asked me, did you have fun at the game? I was like, no, not really. And I'll tell you why, obviously, just so I can take up time. Okay. So let me park my car right quick because I'm here. So Saturday, and I'll take part of the blame, cause normally I wake up like 9:30 and get to the place. Like, this is for like a noon game. I'll get there at 9:30. I'll park at 9:30, and I'll make sure that I'm at the place by at least 10:30, because that's when the gates open to get inside the stadium, when you get so that you can get the best seat, which I got the, first of all, before we even get into the experience at the game, like what happened at the game, I'm going to talk about parking. I'm pretty sure I talked about this with Bryce, and I probably talked about this before the Bryce podcast or whatever. So, I wake up late, so I come here thinking, oh, I guess I'll walk a little bit. But that didn't happen. I had to actually walk a lot of bit because what happened? See, I come to the park that I'm parked at right now, where I normally come. But on this particular, and I should have known. I should have freaking known, because they did this crap last year. But they had the park closed off. And I'm like, what? For a couple of reasons. So the first reason is, it's a public park. How can you, it should be first come, first serve. Like, whoever gets here gets to park here. It's a public park. How can you block off a public park? And, but it gets progressively better. But, as the day goes through or goes by or whatever. And then the second thing I'm thinking, and this is kind of funny, I'm like, how can you not park at the park? It's called the park and you can't park there? Like, and I'm going wild over this. You can't park at the park? If you can't park at the park, then where can you park? That just doesn't make sense. That should be the first place you should be able to park, if anywhere. It's called the park. So I am just like so confused over this. I can't park at the park. This is some bull crap. And that's the main reason I'm upset. That just ruined my day. I'm like, well, can't park at the park. So I had the same thing I did for the Alabama game last year. I parked at my grandma. She doesn't live, like, I'd say I had to walk probably, let me see, from the park to my grandmother's house is about, I'd say, 15 minutes. And from the park to the stadium is about 10 minutes. So it wasn't that bad, but it would have been nice not to walk. Because actually during the Alabama, shout out to Joe and his dad. Because last year at the Alabama game, they actually saw me walking and they picked me up and they took me and Joe. His dad took me and you, Joe. His dad took me and Joe, or Joe and I. I think that's the proper way to say it. I used to always say that wrong in English class. I used to be like, him and me, or me and him and I. I think that's the right way to say it. But I used to always say it wrong. I used to be like, I and him or some crap like that. I still got A's, though. But they took us all the way to the stadium, which was tight. And I guess thinking about it now, that's why I can say that it wasn't that bad. The reason that I can say that it wasn't that bad is because, excuse me for that. I'm not sick, but I feel like I'm kind of congested in some manner. But what is this on my finger? Okay, let me get into this. Let me pause it for a second. I'm going to rub my eye. But, the reason it was so bad during the Alabama game, I don't know if I talked about this for a second. So, this has become a very long story. I didn't expect it to become this long. But, we might get up to an hour. We might get there now. But, I'm still trying to aim for 45 minutes. But, because if this gameplay is playing, some of it is crap. Some, I'll just cut it down. Because I think my gameplay is like right at an hour, so I don't want the podcast to go long. It has to, but I don't really want it to go longer than an hour. Plus, I don't think I have an hour. Well, it's at pretty much 28 minutes, so I have 30 minutes, but we're not going that long. But anyway, this has become a very long story, but let's start at the Alabama game. I talked about the parking. I'm not going to talk about that anymore. Because in both situations, I had to do the same thing. For the game last week and the game versus Alabama, both times I had to park at my grandma's house. I just got lucky during the Alabama game where I didn't have to walk to the stadium. But both times I had to walk from the stadium. But, I'll go more into depth about that. So at the Alabama game, I had to walk to the stadium, whatever. I wanted to get a good seat, which I did not. I got the worst seat I could have gotten. So, I call it the drunk section because they were drinking, obviously. But, it was the fraternity section. And first of all, I am 100% sure that I wasn't even supposed to be up there because they were up there talking. And, I'm actually glad it rained. Because first of all, I was over the overhang, so I wasn't even getting wet. So forget y'all, guys. Forget y'all. I'm doing all right because I'm under the overhang. So I still low. I have my raincoat on, And they're like, what those guys say? They were like, whoever doesn't have, like, I had like a gold armband, because they give students armbands so that you can get back in without having to show your ticket or something like that. But I had an armband. I had a gold armband, but I was in it was the only place I could sit. So I sat there, okay? But they had the fraternity people, the frats and the sororities, they had, I think, checkered wristbands on. And so I heard one of the guys, and before, I'm pretty sure I would have been all right. Because before this, I made like three or four friends. Like, as soon as I got up there, there was this, and I don't know, he might have not even really been my friend, sad face, because he was drunk. But I met this dude named Jake, and like he a very hospitable guy, very courteous. He's like, he had some kind of liquor, some kind of alcohol. He was like, you want some? And I was like, nah, I'm good. Appreciate it, though. So very nice guy. He might have been drunk. That might have been the reason he was so nice, which reminds me, oh, I am so off track, but it's all right. Last Friday, there was a drunk guy where I work, and we stopped selling alcohol at 11:30. And the guy was like, I wouldn't have gave it to him even if it wasn't 11:30, because he was drunk. But he told me he loved me. I just thought I'd put that out there. He told, they weren't even like mad, because I think his friend was all right. But he was like, I love you, man. And that made my night. I was like, I can make it through this night now, because this drunk guy told me he loves me. But I just thought I'd bring that up right now. Not that long of a story. So, they're like, with the wristbands, they're like, anybody who doesn't have a checkered wristband, kick them out. And I'm like, crap. And so I try to, like, without anybody looking, I tried to hide my wristband under my coat. But nobody ever checks it, because they're half drunk and they forgot what they said before they even finished saying it. So to that extent, I didn't have any issues to that point. But just on the game in general, we got blew the freak out by Alabama, because they are the greatest team we have ever seen. Everyone is awaiting the day for Nick Saban to retire. Number one coach, number one recruiter. He will stop winning championships when he feels like it. There's nothing we can do about it. About the only person that has anything close, like, Georgia's not that good at all, but anybody who might potentially have the formula for that is Kirby Smart, just because he coached under him for so long. And I'm not saying we'll beat them this year. I'm not saying we'll go undefeated. I hope we do. I hope all this stuff, but I'm not going to predict it. But that's another reason I didn't have a good time that time, because we were getting blown out. Whenever I tell the story to people, I say it was raining, but it wasn't raining hard, and I wasn't even getting rained on, because I was under the overhang. But at some point, I don't know whether it was the pick six or the block kick or just the Alabama touchdown, but I kid you not, this guy throw, first of all, security, you suck. And I can say this because of a number of things, but I will start out with the smaller thing. First of all, I don't know which game it was in specifically, but I'm not paying $8 for a popcorn and an additional $8 for a drink. So I snuck some crackers up in that mofo during one game last year. I don't remember what game it was, but it was in my raincoat. I don't think it was that game. I think it was a different game, but it was in my coat, and the guy checked it and he was like, what's this? And I was like, man, I was like, crackers. I'm pretty sure I talked about this on the podcast before, but he was like, he didn't even open it up to make sure it was crackers. I just told him it was crackers, which it was crackers, but I'm just saying he didn't open it up and check. And he was like, well, you're not supposed to have food in, but go on ahead. And so that guy, not very smart, but you're cool with me. Like, I'm coming to your line next time. But, and what was the next guy? So my brother didn't even have a freaking ticket. My brother had a cooler full of water, and he went through, and they didn't even check him. They were just like, go on ahead. Didn't check for a ticket. Didn't check to see what's in the thing. Could have been a bomb or five. So my brother just sneaks water into the place. He didn't even sneak it. He went straight through. I'm losing my voice. He didn't even sneak it. He went straight through. And they just let him go. So, you security, you suck too. And let's get to the what happened at the Alabama game. I saw the largest bottle of vodka, probably the only bottle of vodka, but I saw the largest bottle of vodka I have ever seen in my life. Okay, so at some point in the game, it was definitely an Alabama touchdown. I saw a guy throw this bottle, and it went so high in the air, and there is no doubt in my mind. Well, I don't know because I didn't see it. I'm talking about there's no doubt in my mind. There's no doubt in my mind. I always say that. There's no doubt in my mind. But I'm pretty sure. I hope it didn't. I really, really hope it didn't. But I think it hit somebody because the way they reacted, they looked and they were like, oh, crap. And then they ran. Oh, man. I hope they didn't hit. They threw a vodka bottle way up in the air. I was like, what's wrong with you? Don't do that. Don't bring that in here. But it's not their. It is their fault. But security, you let them get through with a vodka bottle? You suck! You freaking suck! How do you let that get in here? I'm gonna bring a gun next time. Well, I shouldn't say that because the, what's the guy's called? Homeland Security be all on me. But what if somebody, let's talk in, I forgot what it's called. Just put it like a scenario, like not a real thing. What if somebody try to bring a gun in here? You just gonna let them? I mean, and last time I came, the game I went to last week, they didn't check me. Like, I didn't have anything on me but my phone and my keys. But they didn't check. Normally they check you. They didn't even check me. So I could have had something on me last week, and I could have got up in there with it. So football security, y'all need to step it up. Y'all need to quit being lazy. I'm not concerned about all the other people. I'm concerned about myself, okay? Selfish. I'm not concerned about y'all. I'm trying to stay alive. I'm trying to survive. No, but I am concerned about everybody. But yeah, y'all need to do something about that so that everybody can be safe. But which I did see a guy up at the top once I got into the stadium. But I don't know what that one guy's gonna do. But I never while in the stadium did I feel unsafe. But just because you don't feel, just because you feel safe doesn't mean you are, you know. I'm not trying to make y'all, put y'all in fear. I'm not trying to say be afraid to do stuff, but I'm just trying to say this is a dangerous world. You better believe that. But it was raining and I walked home. Well, I walked to my grandmother's house, which was not fun. And I had to work, so that topped it off. But and like the night manager is the biggest Alabama fan, but I don't remember seeing him that night. But had I seen him that night, I probably would have heard it from him. But and so then this year I didn't have a good time because it was hot. It was so hot. I kid you not, man. I melted. I lost a few pounds because it was so hot outside. And I had to walk. I had to walk and get there. And then, I had to walk to get there and I was hot. And then I had to sit there in the hot. And let me just say this before I go forward. To people in the student stands, stop standing on the bleachers. If everybody would just stand on the normal floor, then no one would have to stand on the bleachers to see above you. But when people start standing on the bleachers, then the people behind you have to stand on the bleachers. Then the people behind them have to stand on the bleachers, and so on and so on and so on. So just stand on the regular floor and everybody will be able to see. What are you doing? Which nobody was. No, you're not going to be able to see because we're sitting behind the field goal. These are the worst seats. The worst seats in the entire stadium behind the field goal. If you're lucky, you'll catch a football from a field goal. Unless your kicker sucks and he's missing them, which he missed one, but you're still my guy. I don't know his name. I think his name's Rigo or something like that. But you're still my guy, bro. I'm not even mad at you. You, like, this is new to you, so just work hard and you'll be all right. But pep talking the kicker. But like it was hot, and I hate myself so much for this, but it was so hot.
And I was so thirsty.
I paid $4 for a 20-ounce Powerade, which are like 89 cents where I work. That's the highest they are where I work. Sometimes they're lower than that. But the most expensive they get is like 89 cents where I work for a 32-ounce. And I paid $4 for a 4-ounce. And then I paid $4. I got two drinks, okay? That's how thirsty I was. Then I paid $4 for Dasani water, 20-ounce. And I hate myself so much for that. I should have just left and went home. But I didn't want to leave and go home. Because Georgia was, like, in a close game with Nichols. When I said last week that we were going to beat them, I didn't think it was going to be by 2 points. I thought it was going to be by 200 points. But a win is a win, and I projected it. So I was right, and you were wrong. So I'm just going to throw that out there. But yeah, man, paying $8 for some drinks. And like the fountain, the refillable one was like a fountain drink. It was $7. So I could have paid less for that and got refills. But the only drink, well, they probably were giving out water, but I didn't want to buy a cup and get water. But the only drinks were like sodas. And I was like, that's not going to do nothing. That's going to make it worse. So I was like, I'm not buying a soda. And I saw people are so wasteful, but I saw people like drinking like out of one time and they were leaving their cups like under the bleachers. And I thought, because I've done this before at the movie theater. We cleaned it out really good. Like, trust me. We cleaned out a large cup at the movie theater, and we got free drinks with that thing. I don't know how my brother thought of that. That was genius. We didn't buy a cup. Like, we found a dirty cup and we cleaned it out, and we went to the folks and we were like, can we get a refill? And they gave us a refill. So we paid nothing and we got this free drink. So if y'all ever, hey, I'm giving y'all ideas, man. I'm giving y'all these smart ideas. If y'all want a free drink, man, just make sure you clean it out good. Make sure you clean it out real good now, because we ain't trying to get sick. So make sure you do that, and you can get you a free drink. You're welcome. If you don't get anything else, well, I have some important stuff to talk about. But if you don't get, this is one of the things. If you don't get anything out of this podcast, get that out of it. You can get some free drinks. You just got to clean the cup. I think it has to be like large, so don't try to... the movie theater I go to, it's any size you can get refills. And I know, because I had to pee so hard. I had to pee so bad when I went to see, what's that movie with Franco and Emma Roberts? Nerve. That's a good movie. That's a pretty good movie. When I went to see that, I had to pee so freaking bad, man. Too much information, I know. But we're still talking about this pee stuff. Because I drank both of those drinks. Like, I don't know the exact amount of time, but I drank them very, very quickly together. Like, I drank them because I was really thirsty and probably close to dehydrated. Which is why I got a water and Powerade, because the Powerade help. I think Powerades help with, because they have electrolytes. I think they help with dehydration. But I was sweating so bad that when I drank those, I didn't even have to pee. And that's probably because I sweated all of that crap out. But and it was a close game. So that sucked, because I could have left early, could have been at home sleeping, because I had to go to work after that too. But at least I'm just glad we won, and hopefully we'll win tomorrow. But and I don't know if any of that made sense or not. But if it didn't, then just leave a question, leave a comment, like I've been telling y'all to do, which no one has been doing. But if that's how y'all gonna do it, then I'm just gonna keep talking about stupid crap. Cause y'all don't want to ask questions, so that's fine with me. But before I talk about the last thing we want to talk about, and hopefully this won't be too long because it's getting hot in this car, and really it's time to go to class, and I think there might be reading for this class and I haven't read, but what was I gonna say? I think next week, this video, whatever you want to call it, that I'm doing right now is my 99th. And so the plan is for me next week to do something special for my 100th video, which I might actually do 3 videos. But I guarantee that I'm doing two. I guarantee I'm going to do 2 videos, because one of them, I'm going to do a song. I'm going to sing a song. I don't know what song I'm going to sing. Leave a comment if you think there's a song that I should sing. And I'm going to do a podcast. And hopefully the plan for the podcast, I'm going to do it with Facecam. So I'm going to do at least 2 videos, maybe 3. So tune in next week and we'll have some special stuff, I guess. But the last thing that I wanted to talk about today was, let me pause right quick, because I want to see exactly how I worded it on Twitter. Like I said last week, I pretty much put what I'm going to talk about the day or the week or whatever. I tweet what I'm going to talk about that week. What did I put? I want to see what it is, that word. Okay. What I put was, you're just as important. And what I'm talking about here is, often we tend to put actors, musicians, I don't know, maybe presidents, or like people, public figures, or whatever, athletes, we tend to put them above the rest of the people, which is wrong, because they're not better, they're not more important. And here goes this inspirational stuff for the day. But they're not better, they're not more important than any of the rest of us. Are they possibly doing something that we wish we were doing? Yeah. Are they probably making more money than we are? Yeah. But that doesn't make them more important than us. And that, I feel like a lot of depression, I feel like a lot of jealousy, a lot of unhappiness and envy, I feel like it stems from that. I feel like we look at somebody else's life and we're like, man, I wish that was my life. Like, I hate them, or I'm putting them up there. Like, oh, they're so much greater than I am. They're not. Just because, like we're all in my mind, like, we're all the same. Like, where you work, what you do, that doesn't make you better than somebody. Cause like in my mind, yeah, you could be rich, but you could have the worst attitude in the world, and you could be a celebrity. You could be like very, very quote unquote successful, and but you could have a bad attitude. And if you have a bad attitude, I don't care who you are, I don't like you. But you could be somebody poor, but you could be kind and compassionate, and I do like you. So like, there's no big me's and little you's, or big you's and little me's. Like, we're just as important. And I hope y'all know that, like, even though you might look up to somebody, you're not really, like, you shouldn't really, I want to say it like that, but you shouldn't really look up to somebody, like, because you can be that if you want to. You can. Don't say what if. Don't say that. Don't say what if. Just do it. Just do it. Don't let your dreams be dreams. Yes, you can. You can do it. Cause like we put people, like, and the reason I'm saying this is cause this guy on YouTube, he's a gamer. I watch a lot of gamers on YouTube. But this is basically what this guy said on whatchamacallit, on YouTube. His name is Mr. Dalek. But he plays games and people donate. And he's like, he said something like, some guy donated, and he was like, obvious donations are optional. So like, he doesn't really care if people donate or not. But he was like, what did he say? He said, like, somebody donated like $200 to him. And he was like, if you need a refund for that, like, I'll definitely give it to you, because there's no way you should be donating all that to just me. And like, the way I heard it, I'm just like you. We're just the same. And he has over 1 million subscribers, so he's pretty big on YouTube. But basically what he said there was, we're the same. Like, I'm just gaming, just like I like gaming, just like you like gaming. We're the same. It just happens that a lot of people like what I do. And anybody can be that. You can be somebody that people like what you do. Like, so just keep that in mind, y'all, that you're just as important as the president. You're just as important as the best LeBron James, or who's the best football player? I don't know, J.J. Watt. You're just as important as Beyonce. Do you have those same talents? No. But you know what? Do you have those same abilities? No. But you know what? That's what makes you special, because I guarantee there is something that you can do that a lot of people can't do. And that's what we need to realize. Although nobody can do everything, everybody can do something that somebody else can't do. And that's what makes us special. And that's what makes us unique. But it's really hot in this car. So and it's probably hot outside, but it's definitely not as hot as it is in this car. I am sweating at 9 o'clock in the morning. But like I said before, I hope everyone has a great day. Let's keep it positive. Let's be nice to one another today. And hopefully this will be out today. Hopefully this will be out by midnight Saturday morning, the 17th. And as always, be easy.